All right, thanks for joining us today. Today we are gonna talk about how to react to a large business setback. Setbacks are natural. You're always gonna have issues and problems that come up in business. There's nothing you can do to avoid them. That's why you need to always preemptively think ahead, plan ahead, make your adjustments, and move on, right? So I'm gonna give you some examples. I'm not gonna give you specifics, but I'll give you some examples of some business setbacks that we've experienced. And I guess how I roll with it or adjust to them, and I guess how do we react to those problems, right? So I'll give you some examples. One is disgruntled employees, right? Everybody's gonna have disgruntled employees sometimes, whether they have a reason to complain or they not have a reason to complain, they'll complain at some point, I'm sure. but disgruntled employees. Now you could have situations where employees talk bad back to a customer, or mouth off to customers, or damage something, or break something, or whatever. Or you could have any of those things. I've had many, not many, but I've had issues before with employees. I've even had employees flick off customers on the road. I've had employees break customers' things by accident on purpose. I've had vehicles destroyed. I've had doors messed up. There's car openings gone wrong. All kinds of things. So it's how you react to those and how you move forward and how you make adjustments and also put into place policies or procedures so that this doesn't happen again, right? So disgruntled employees, you deal with the situation per situation, and depending on the situation will depend on how you react to it. But say, for instance, your customer, you have an employee that, mouths off to a customer, does something, pisses them off, and now they're angry at them, and then they go leave a bad review on you, right? So you got to resolve that at some point. So you either need to call back the customer and apologize, or have the employee call back and apologize if they're the ones that, really need to own up to it. But it's not so much the problem that you have, it's how you react to the problem and how you move forward, right? So disgruntled employees, that one is different for each employee, but you address the issue like you did, for instance, you made the customer mad, you call, you apologize, you address the issue, you try to move forward, right? Sometimes you can't. Sometimes employees just don't gel with your system, or sometimes they're just bad apples and need to cut them loose, right? So we've had situations where we've had large setbacks, like a vehicle. I had one of my guys driving home one night, stopped the stop sign, looked and started to go through, and then here comes a car, slam right through the intersection, never stopped, right through a stop sign. Basically hit the vehicle, spun it around, and fell over on its side, I believe is what it was on. It was on its back. It had flipped over on its back, and he was fine. Employee was fine. But once the situation started unfolding, the worse it got. And I'll explain how that happened. Basically, I had just paid off this van, just paid it off 2 weeks prior, right? Then, so employee is fine, by the way, so I'm not gonna pretend like that's not a big issue. He's fine, everything's fine on that end, so we'll ignore that. But the van is on his back, I just paid it off, right? Now I can't run calls, I'm down a van, I have to get a new van, I have to get insurance money over, I have to finish all that out, I have to build out a whole new van, put all new stock in it because this one's totaled, right? So that's a major setback. We've had that happen one time, and we've also had other vehicles get hit and totaled and things like that too. But in that situation I'm talking about, actually, she was not of age to drive, she had no driver's license, she was not legal, and she had no insurance. So it was kind of like the worst of everything. So fortunately, we ended up getting it worked out. I lost money on it. You get a little bit of piece back, and now I got to buy a new vehicle and finance a new vehicle, and I just had a paid off vehicle. And besides all the tools that were damaged. So, on that particular situation, he didn't do anything at fault. So there's not much to learn from there, except for just really make sure everybody's slowing down before going through the intersection. So you can't really, address an issue and move forward on that situation. You just kind of have to roll with it, get the team together. All right, guys, let's go out here. Let's clean out this van, take all the parts out, sort them all out, put them away. Hopefully a new vehicle comes in, build it all out, stock it all up, and get it back on the road. It's all you can do is move forward, right? So we've had all other setbacks, like I sent an employee to open a car one time. I don't even know how it happened, but he put a giant dent in the side of their car. like, here's the top of the window, here's the bottom of the door down here. It was like down here. We don't even touch down there. We're way up here when we're opening a car. So I don't know what happened on that, but he put a dent in the side of the vehicle, $700 dent. So a $65 car opening job turns into a $700 bill. I've had the same employee actually back into a garage. I was at a customer's house. So yeah, we've had our experiences, but you address it. And in that situation, we had problem with the problem of the problem. We had to cut loose that situation because it just became more and more of a not paying attention kind of a thing. So you have to be able to trust your employees too, because they're taking care of all your investments, your company investments. So those are some examples of things we've had happen. We've also had big projects fall out. You know, you get all the parts together, you do all this research and all this quoting and site visits and everything and arrangements, get right down, get in the deposit, and then something happens, right? And then the whole project's gone. So I would say this, how to react to large business setbacks. The best way to react is not to sit there and then complain about, oh, poor me, I can't believe this happened to me. Oh, me, you know, feel sorry for me, right? That's not gonna work. Especially when you have a group of guys in the company as well. If you start bringing everything down and complaining and saying it's all horrible and feeling defeated, then it's gonna bring the vibe down of everybody too. Or you can come out with a positive attitude and be like, all right, guys, let's get at it. Let's get this thing separated. You know what we got to do, right? We got to clean this guy out, get our parts out, get it into a new vehicle, build it out, get it on the road so we can make some money and you can do some jobs. So the best way to react to business setbacks is have a positive, I don't know why I just lost my train of thought there, but have a positive attitude. Sorry. Have a positive attitude towards the situation. We got to present a positive attitude and, hey, we'll overcome this as a team together. It's not a big deal. We're going to do it because nothing's going to stop us, right? Whatever that may be. You want to assure your people that all is well. This is going to happen. It's natural. Things are always going to happen. Who knows what else is going to happen? I'm sure many crazy things are going to happen over the years. You try to avoid them all you can. You try to prevent them. But the number one thing you can do is don't be surprised like, oh, I can't believe this happened to me, because eventually things like this will happen to you in business. It's just gonna happen. So whether it's a total vehicle or damaging someone's product or whatever it may be, things will happen. So the best thing to do is have a positive mentality. If there's something you can learn from the situation, take that, make the adjustments and policies or and ways you do things, procedures or whatever it may be. If you had someone damage something when he was doing the install, we'll find out why he damaged that. And is there a way to avoid that going forward? And if so, tell everybody in your team, show them how to avoid that and put it out there. And then you know that thing, that instance that happened should never happen again. Shouldn't. It still may, but it shouldn't happen again because you've covered all your bases. You've informed everybody. You brought them all together on it and you've learned from it and you grew from the situation. So how to react to large business setbacks. Summary, positive attitude, come up with if there's something that can be changed to prevent it in the future, put those policies or procedures in place and do so. You also want to make sure that you're limiting the risk as much as possible, right? Have regular meetings, talk to your guys, bring up risk things that are risk to your business. For instance, driving habits, right? In ours, we have tracking on the vehicle so we can say, oh, this is your driving habits. Hey man, you got a lot, your driver rating is really low. It looks like you're doing the XYZ, you know, how are we gonna fix that? Well, you know, slow down, you know, or whatever it may be. So checks and balances helps you avoid a lot of big problems too. So make sure you're thinking ahead, you're planning ahead. Imagine, I always try to imagine like, well, what's the worst that can happen? Okay, well, I'm gonna be aware of that and maybe let's do this just so that doesn't happen, right? So you want to think things out a little bit if you can. If you can't, if it just happened, then the way you react, the way you adjust to it, and the way you attack the problem, everybody will see that in the company as well, right? So if you act like a child, you throw a tantrum, you're throwing stuff around the store, you know, how dare me, and kicking stuff, punching walls and stuff, that's just ridiculous. You know, that doesn't do anything for anybody, and it's childish. So, and you look defeated, right? You don't want to look defeated. So the whole thing is to, as a business owner, everything's on you, all the risk is on you, everything's on you. So you want to make sure you limit those risks, but things are going to happen regardless. So it's all about the attitude going forward, the processes and procedures you put in place to avoid those, and you grow as a human, you grow as a leader, and then your team also respects you a little bit more because of the way you handle the situation. So hopefully that helps you with handling business setbacks. I mean, there's not a checklist I can give you specifically, but that's just how I deal with them. Usually a positive attitude and a more, here's a problem, what's the solution to get that problem taken care of, or what's the procedures I need to do to avoid this? Write them down, put a procedure in place, go over meetings, go over your high-risk situations in your meetings often, so that's fresh in your employees' mind. Oh, I need to drive safe. Oh, that's right, I need to use my hands-free when I'm driving so I don't get an accident. Oh, I need to use this tool so I don't end up scratching that, or whatever it is, right? So hopefully that helped you, and hopefully this will help you run your business or help you adjust to setbacks that you may have. Thanks for tuning in. Please follow us on Instagram, LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook. We're on all the social media platforms. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon for notifications. We appreciate you tuning in as always, and thanks for the support.